the needs, yeah, of your learners and being able to form a lesson plan. Actually, this is now a lesson plan, but also now I can I'm very, very proud of all of you being able to get all what the gist of it. Actually, it's one lesson. Only this part is for this struggling or so, but everybody contributed, although they are struggling learners. It's not only that, oh yeah, you are struggling, you are on level, you are highly able. They have to have, you have to be in one class. You will be working together afterwards anyway. So what I'm trying to say here, it's flexible grouping. It's not only, here, the struggling. You sit down here, you are the on level. Sit down, I will. Now, it consists on one lesson. I know you are doing already in your class. You are dealing with them with a human heart, so you don't want to put them in a difficult situation. So helping you, allow them to help one another. Yeah, in your class, usually you do that. This is just to relate. Yeah, you are trying to relate what you did in class, bringing at them. That's the purpose of this actually session that we have. Yeah. Okay. Now the others, you have actually, I know you have done your, and then later you will get your check. Okay. You're going to be. Okay. Let's continue. Because we have set a show time actually later. Yeah. Another show time. This one is already a show time actually. Yeah. And a while ago, it was designed by, later on at the end of this session, before it ends, I would like you to design your own stuff, your own. Here it was designed by, we took it from this team, and we try to develop it, how we are going to do it in class, you see? And it becomes one lesson. Later, we have to think for our own. Activities. I will give you a lot of books here later, a lot of books, and we have actually Story Central. You are teaching Story Central?
No.
Some of you. But for those, for our guests, you are high school teachers, yeah? Senior high school and junior high school. I will give you also from Smart Choice, I think, this one. I have a lot of books here. Later, you are going to look into the books, and then we create activities for considering all the struggling, the on level, and highly able, and with learning styles, visual, kinesthetic, auditory, and with learning preferences. They like the arts. They like music, and they like what multiple intelligences we have. Actually, when you look at your what is it, handout? Actually, this is from the handout. I just put it on the what is it on the slide. So this differentiated instruction originated by Carol Ann Tomlinson. Carol, we have Carol. We have Sherry here. Not Carol. Yeah. So this is. It was mentioned that it is this. It is actually considering individual learning styles and levels of readiness first before designing a lesson. Readiness is the ability, actually. Ability to be able to accept the concept, the ability, the skills and the knowledge. Yeah, the knowledge. Are they ready to have to undergo the topic or to handle the topic? So if you have differentiating instruction, it means you are teaching the same material, yeah, to all students you have here in your class using many kinds of instructional strategies. A while ago, you have already done it. Those are instructional strategies. Somebody says mind mapping. Mind mapping is one part of actually graphic organizing. Graphic organizers. Graphic organizers look good. You go into the deeper into that, there are a lot. It will help your students engage, especially in a reading passage. Yang berat-berat itu, graphic organizers will help you out. For Parlin, who's dealing with KTSP or the curriculum 13, they have beban-nya itu ya, the burden of the teachers in high school. in high school is to be able to bring their students to be able to do the national exam. That's the ito the rebook dito buru-buru to kaya ko lang ito. So actually there are drawbacks of teaching for the exam. A language to supposedly is not teaching language for the exam. It's actually teaching the language to be able to communicate, to be able to use it. But we could not blame the teachers in high school because they have to catch up. Otherwise, it's a reputation for the school. Oh, there's a target. Yeah. They have to do test-taking strategies accordingly. Test-taking strategies for the national exam. Pwede niyang diyajarin to. They have to identify the text. And so, fun, it's not actually very enjoyable pa, yeah, for the students. To the students, napaksa. They are forced to do it because now it's not fun for them. Maybe there are times if you are not catching up, pa, you can integrate some other meaningful and engaging activities that they enjoy. If you are not catching up with time, if you have still time. So make your class then lively, enjoyable for the students. Okay, so now you can do that with differentiated instruction, actually. Now, you can read this one actually from your handouts, yeah? The who practice differentiation has, you plan, the teacher will plan the lessons based on the learning styles and preferences. And based also on their shared interest, topic, or ability for assignment. Yeah? Formative. A while ago, I asked you about formative assessment. Ito ada apa yang red? Apa? Kebanyakan green sih. When you said about formative assessments, yeah, you know. But there are also blue. So formative actually is ongoing assessment. So ongoing assessment, what is ongoing assessment? So as a teacher, you are able, it's not a test, but being able to see or assess or see the understanding of your students while you are teaching. Or at the end of the lesson, were they able to understand what I am trying to say here? That is ongoing assessment. So you can actually go back if they don't get it the next time. That's the basis. Yeah, so we call it normative. I formative or ongoing assessment. Now, I usually use cards for, we call it exit cards for assessments. Very quick. As a teacher, you can write, you can ask question for each of them. And then they will write it down here. For example, me, I will ask you, what do you understand by what is it, differentiated instruction? Then you write it here. This is very small, but usually you write that before going home, before leaving the class, you ask them to write. Then they can go if they have already written something here. And they cannot go, they cannot, you cannot have your lunch if you are not able to write something. Yeah, so we call it accept cards. So that's one way, very quick way of you knowing whether your students understand what you are trying to say. Yeah. You have cards. You have response cards. Response a while ago. The one I showed you. And this one is the exit cards. So when they, usually I ask them to do it in a post. You can ask them to do it in a post-it. Yeah? Later I will ask you to do it in a post-it. You cannot go home. Okay. Now, so that is the formative or ongoing assessment. You can manage the classroom to create a safe and supportive environment. I think I don't need to discuss that because usually as a teacher, that's our aim. We support them, we help them out, it is safe. And this is actually related, the last one. Continually assess and adjust lesson content to meet student needs. Yeah? That is related. So you continuously assess. Because of the it is ongoing assessment. You want to know whether your students understand or not, or what do they need more other topics in order to understand the concept, something like that. Okay. Now, so according to Carol, Auntie Carol, I don't know whether she's still alive or not.
Yeah.
Because this is an old theorem, an old method in 1999. Where were you in 1999? Oh, yeah. But of course, it has been improved and improved, updated and updated. So they are still using formal schools are using it actually in the US. They are using it in their textbooks. Yeah? So four ways to differentiate instruction. This is another way. Don't be confused. Yeah. So there are content, katanya, process, products, and learning. You can read it in your handouts. Because we don't have a lot of time, so I want you to read the handouts there. Strategy to differentiate the content, katanya. According, and makanya I mentioned about Bloom's taxonomy. Pasti tahu kan Bloom's taxonomy? Anyway, I will share with Mbak Dian the... this is the PowerPoint, and you can send all to you. You have your emails, yeah? Because if you print it out, then it's so many, yeah? That's why I summarized it, it's here. And actually, you can also browse, because I have just browsed. I used it in my class before, but not a lot of theories. Now there are a lot of things that you can see. So this is the relating to the Bloom's taxonomy, so we can differentiate the content of the the content of the reading that we are giving to the students. Maybe ada remembering, understanding, yes, still remember that? Remembering, understanding, applying. So these are the what we call lower or order thinking skills and higher order thinking skills. Okay, so you read your handouts, yeah, for that. So these are just explanations. Students who are unfamiliar with the lesson could be asked to complete tasks on the lower levels, remembering and understanding. Kanya yung familiar to remembering and understanding hindi. And students with some mastery could be asked for application to apply and analyze the content. Students who have high levels of mastery could be asked to complete tasks in areas of evaluating and grading. But of course, we are going to give chance for them to go higher. But there are a lot of scaffolding activities, scaffolding supporting activities. Yeah. Okay. Now there are examples over there in your handouts. You have it with you actually. These are examples of differentiating activities. Maths, vocabulary, words. Actually, it's your activities that you are doing in class. Ano pa ulos sama aja si? Huh? But you know already here how who are the right students to receive this, the right students to receive this, so understanding will be going on, will be achieved. Yeah. So you see, to ada PowerPoint, ada yang harus bikin PowerPoint kan? Okay. So you try to analyze that one. Actually, this is think of a situation. I think this is in order. Yeah, this is an order. Okay. That process apalagi itu. What is the process? This is actually, it has something to do. I'm just trying to organize this one according to what Ibu Carol said. Tadi tata, sekarang Ibu. Nanti grandma. Grandma Carol. Okay. So, process, the process of learning itu. The student has a preferred learning style. Then successful differentiation includes delivering the materials to each style. Okay, now, because of this reason that not all students require the same amount of support from the teacher, ada kan yang independent. There are students who are more independent. There are students who could choose to work in pairs, as I told you a while ago. There are students who can work in pairs, small groups, or individually. It depends. But it doesn't mean that, dia kan individual, selalu mau sendiri, ya udah gak biarin. Gitu. But you have to train that particular student to be able to work in pairs or groups. Now, some students also may benefit from one-on-one interaction with the teacher. Usually, the Montessori kind of teaching, you know, Montessori, it's one-on-one. But in our class, we have how many students? We have Ibu Yuza. How many students Ibu Yuza?
30.
Huh? 36. 36? Oh my gosh. The, you can only identify later the strugglings and the highly able. I had students in my experience way back in the Philippines. I have 64 Ibu. Very large class. And I am, it's like this room, I'm not sure. Looking at them. So who I only know is the highly able student and the struggling. Yung natura-tura, udah masa bodoh, udah saya gak kenal itu. 64, imagine. Now, another thing lagi kalau, apa, how do you call that? How to handle large classes with Ibu Celestin, we did that somewhere else. I don't know, I forgot. Oh, well, oh, yeah. So, with our partners actually doing things like this. Yeah, that's our relationship. So, we can have that. Maybe Ibu Celestin is going to do that. What is the title in Ibu Celestin's next month? Dian, Pak Dian?
Yes.
Ibu Celestin, what is the title for next month? Okay, now anyway, in chatty banget. Yeah, okay, anyway, process. Tadi apa tadi? Content. And then, after that, process. Tadi masih process nih. Examples of differentiating the process. You provide textbooks with visual and word learners. Ini banyak saya textbook di sini. Lagi promosi buku apa? Punya temu buku kan nih, Ibu Lucy? Okay, now, you can provide textbooks for those visual and word learners. Ini yang suka baca, visual. Jadi, kasih textbooks lah tuh dia biarin dia di pojok di sana, dia baca-baca. Gitu. And then for the auditory learners to listen to audiobooks, audio. Oh, kita ada ya, yang apa, iTunes-nya. For the, yeah, you have a lot of audio lah, Pak, in your school, ya. Media kan, ada kan, multimedia. So, no problem with that. Now for the kinesthetic learners, the opportunity to complete an interactive assignment online. Kinesthetic itu bisa online, kita kasih research juga, dia move around gitu loh. Bukannya yang nari saja, gitu, bukan itu aja. Ya, it's not the only kinesthetic activities. A lot of kinesthetic activities where they can move. Gallery walk. Gallery walk, you put all their, what is that? Finished product. And then they will go around and analyze all this. And they are walking already. In order not for them to be able to sleep. You are going to sleep. Because these are... Okay, the learning environment, katanya, it's very important. So what is the learning environment? Break some students into reading groups to discuss the assignment. They are a while ago. I break down you into groups. You allow students to read individually if preferred. If we have more time, I allow you that. Create quiet spaces where there are no distractions. Here we have a lot of distractions. Why? Because Ibu Luz is very chatty. Yeah, you cannot do the work. Anyway, this is just a training. If you go back to your classroom, then you have to create this learning environment. Yeah, good learning environment. And we have other strategies. I think I could not explain it to you all of this. Yeah, we have not much time. You can browse. There is in the, what is it? In the link. But you know already something about flexible tiered lessons. Actually, it was step-by-step lesson. Response except card, this is what I'm talking about a while ago. Multiple texts, so a lot of texts, reading and study buddies. Yeah, wherein they are going to have partners in reading. Any anchor activities? Anchor activities actually are activities done ongoing. So, like for example, learning logs, you know, book review, it takes a period of time. We call them anchor activities. Yeah? So, if you want to know more about that, how to do it, I have given you, dimana to saya kasih, at the last page, last, bukan last page, apa ya? There is the link.
Page 3.
Oh, yeah, 3. You can explore on that link, and then you can find all this kind of other strategies. Graphic organizers, yeah. Okay? So this is a book, Anchor Activities, like learning logs, yeah, Anchor Activities. Tiered lessons, step-by-step lessons, wherein you have step 1, 2, 3, 4, trying to consider the ability of your students. Adjust, change, okay? Okay, aja deh. Anna, this is over to you actually from your own group accordingly. You based on the lesson pages given to you, we are going to create, kayaknya gak ada waktu sedikit kali, tapi just very quickly, ya ada questions lagi, so very quickly, I just would like to share with you, ini ya, gimana saya tahu? Who are teaching Smart Choice? Oh yes, you are teaching Smart Choice. So you're familiar with that. Since we don't have much time, I don't think you have already tried a while ago, yeah? So I think, is that enough, the practice that you have? Did you get it? So because if you do this, we might not have time, we better do discussion and summing up, yeah? Because you have already tried how to implement it. But the thing is, you have not tried to create yet your own. And tadi masih dari gambar itu. But I can give you this one. Ah, yeah, I have already given you the page 6 actually, page 5 and 6. That is an example of creating activity for struggling learners, for all level learners, highly able learners. You try to see? Can you see? Number page 6. There is the activity 2, pyramid frame. So you have your questions already, and then you create the pyramid accordingly. It depends on your questions. And C, you can ask the students to make a summary based on the answers in the pyramid frame. And you have struggling learners there. You can find the characters and draw comic characters representing them. Somebody did it a while ago. Comics. Saya belum cerita. Yeah, udah. So we don't need to do that. So you have already done it. On level learners, do the activities as they are given. Jadi activities yang ada di sini. Nah itu on level, yeah. Now highly able, you remove the questions and let the students formulate their own questions. Or you can ask them to change the beginning and the ending of the story. Kalau masih pintar juga, dia bosan. Kalau usually the students, if they are pretty smart, they easily get bored. So that's why we have to pay attention to them. Oh, masih pintar juga ya. Bikin cerita lain yang tadi dia. The one you did a while ago. Yang ada options. The situation is not there. What's the situation? It's not the same situation, but it's the same feeling. The same feeling. Yeah, kan? Nah, jadi anak-anak. Jadi the point is they don't learn on the same way, you know. Enggak sama. It's not uniform. Lain-lain dia. But of course, as a teacher, you know that already. Ibu Luz, kami udah tahu juga kayak gitu kok. Ibu Luz, ulang-ulang lagi. No, I'm trying to emphasize. And then you will see the wonder of it. When you say, oh, anak-anak ko senang. And especially, Ibu Yuza and what is Parlin, they are dealing with students in formal school. They have to what is it, to cater to the curriculum, the syllabus. Harus ngejar-ngejar gitu kan. Because you have to be evaluated kan after that. Have you done it? Then the students also, bukan itu aja yang ngejar, siapa yang ngejar-ngejar? Kepala sekolah apa bukan? Orang tua juga. Nah, orang tua kalau nggak lulus tuh di... That's why. Okay, so but then we have to provide them also joy in the classroom. That's what I'm saying. If we are happy, then all of us are happy. Wow, okay. Now, so any other concerns? Because we have only 15 minutes. Yes. It's actually more on not question and answer, but if you want to ask questions, yes, somebody is going to answer. If sharing, if you have some experiences, very important for all of us to know, like Marvin and Ibu Yusa, they are from the formal school and we are from the non-formal sector. So maybe they can you share any difficulties you have? Kaya kita bisa bantu aja ya. Okay, any questions then? Any questions? Any questions? Habis itu kita joget lagi. Memang ada sih yang gak mau joget, ya. But anyway, we are going to close it with some wisdom, a good reason. Do you teach your classes with socks in school? Pakai lagu gak kalau ngajak? Oh, yeah, okay. Good.
That's why, because in 2011, we have possession of our song.
Oh!
This,
yeah, because in every class, in curriculum 2013, we have the part of song, and it is becoming the assessment.
Oh,
yeah,
it is
because,
an assessment.
Yeah, that's an assessment because the assessment is included in the SIMDIC. In the SIMDIC, jadi kita nilainya dari komputer langsung gitu. Jadi itu ada bagian itu kan. Prof. Selepas itu sudah dipetakan. It is a mapping, it is a map, it is a bus, and it is a map into the system, system, my system.
Okay.
System must complete. Thank you.
Okay.
Well,
we use that. And you share about anything that, that is what you feel, what you are happy about in formal school or in your class. The, maybe the behavior of the students are quite different. And then we have big classes, yeah? 36 is a big. In Mia, oh, teriak-teriak tuh guru bu. Oh, di kelas 30 aja bu. Eh, itu lah boleh. Tuh, kan gak muat juga sih. So we cannot stay in our classrooms in small, in
Pramuka is very, but other branches, very small classrooms, if you cannot accommodate 36. 36,
yeah.
How
did you manage to
teach that? Microphone. Whenever they are, my school is, most of the students very slow learners.
Because most of them live beside Kali Ciliwung.
I see.
It's hard for teach them. We have to repeat many times for one lesson. Yeah, because they maybe only one or two students understand what I explain.
So, Is there any other strategies that you want or techniques you want to share with them to use that? Because they have to repeat and repeat. Because the students don't understand.
Yeah, they have very limited vocabularies too.
Oh, very limited vocabularies. Okay.
They don't know the meaning of go.
Oh.
Although there are many texts using the word go, but some of them still didn't know the word. Not only the idea.
Okay, if we use Anpa Parlin came here to get something. And then there's problem. I'm talking about differentiated instruction and so on and so forth. So how can that help their students who don't understand the vocabulary? Okay. Anyway, we use that. Maybe I can see something a little bit. Oh yeah. So yeah, she's helping.
Now, I just want to share what I have ever experienced. I used to teach in Akademi Kebidanan. English is not their, what is it, cup of tea? they hate English. When they were in senior high school and junior high school, they said that they hate English, so that's why they choose another thing instead of English. But then, I think that's a challenge for me. I know that the main constraint is that vocabulary. And I start giving them in a very, low level vocabulary, but it is in a fun way and it motivates them. So for example like this, if I want to give them a word, I cut letters into pieces A until Z. So for one A, I provide 10, and then for B, same thing. And then after that, I put them into groups. I believe that not all of them are low level students. I believe that there are smart. There are some of them who are smart. So I put them into groups and then I give them the meaning, the description. Sometimes I put them the picture to help them understand what it is. So picture, the meaning, and the letters that they are going to rearrange. That is the first. And then the second time, I ask them to use the gadget. I believe that right now, most students, they have the gadget, right? We can make good use of that. But it can be in an interesting way. So for example, like this. We make a group line or group WA, and then there we make some kind of quiz. I make some kind of quiz. So now I have this word. Then they have to find it out outside of the class. Outside of the class, when coming to the class, they have already got the answer. And then if they can answer that word, the word that will lead to the topic I am going to discuss that day, then I will give them a token of appreciation, something like that. So actually there are many things we can do to help them motivate themselves. And then add more vocabulary.
Okay, that's one. That's a very long technique. Yeah. No, but that's how it is done. Yeah, we have to be very, very creative and patient. Repetition, but it's also one. You have to repeat and repeat. Yeah, you are right. You have to repeat your lesson because you know later that, oh yeah, they still don't understand. And then you repeat. We have you can actually, what is it? If you come to Lia next time again, so our teachers are going to share strategies with all of you, yeah, with all of you. And then if you have some what is need in your school for a trainee, we can work together. Yeah, we come to your school and then we give training, something like that. Because for the, yeah, because here at Lia, we are actually focusing on so many strategies. But in formal school, I am not saying that you don't have strategies. You have a lot of strategies. But sometimes you are carried away with the aim of the national exam. Yeah, so that is the challenge in the formal school. Whether we like it or not, teachers in formal school, we have to deal with the national exam. Okay, so any other questions? Yes, over there.
Okay. Ma'am, in my understanding that we can use this differentiated instruction in only in some sessions during one term for one class. Am I right or
only
not?
Only one session?
No, not on one session, but only for some sessions, in my understanding. No, I mean, like, for me, I think it's going to be difficult for me to carry, because there are some units to cover with with several difficulties. So probably I would like to apply this to some sessions in a class in for one term. So, but not for all that, sessions.
Yes,
that's what
right,
I mean.
You are right.
Yeah, because like, and also my another question is, how about if none of the students are the artful ones? So I mean, like, they will have problems in that. Or
okay, good, a very good question. So this strategy, because you are the one who knows your class better, where you know where to insert it. It's not always that every day you are going to deal with the differentiated instruction, but if it is automatic in with you in class, he looks bored. So maybe you can give other activities, and that's it. Yeah. And then your second point is, what did you say a while ago?
Yeah. Well, if none of the students are artistic,
you could not impose on what they don't want to do. So it doesn't matter. That's why I said, if they don't like music, not like movie, it doesn't matter. So you don't, you created already that instruction, yeah, that differentiated instruction. So you have this, you draw, and then you do this within, if nobody wants it, yeah, it doesn't matter. Yeah, you change to the other one, which is easier. It's not only drawing, maybe, what? Now.
Singing or miming.
So we are the one who draw. We prefer the drawings. Yeah, and then let them produce the language. Because our aim here is for them to be able to produce the language. Then you know the class cannot draw. But you can also give, as what you said, the teachers will provide. The most important thing, they produce the language. Yeah. Okay? Yeah. So here is actually the conclusion. It's not always... the summing up here, I just read the summing up. The benefit, the benefit of differentiated instruction, according to Auntie Carol, Grandma Carol, effective for highly ability students as well as students. This instruction is effective for high ability students, katanya. And then, as well as students with mild to severe disabilities, yang punya. Disabilities yang ada punya kelainan, learning difficulties. This will be good. And then students take on more responsibility according to their research. Yeah, this is according to them. But if we use it, we might be able to find other benefits. So students take on more responsibility of their own learning. They are responsible because they are given tasks. Yeah, students appear to be more engaged in learning. They will be their focus. Yeah, they are more focused and they enjoy the activity. There are fewer discipline problems in classroom. Yeah, because I tried this to my university students. But I don't know with the the children. I have tried it with the children. So it means because the activities are according to their preference, so they are more they enjoy it more. That's what I see with my children of class, young children classes. Because I usually do it in my children classes and my the past years I only teach children and then the university student. Anyway, I trained the teachers who do OP also for children classes. So that's why I'm down to the okay, anyway. The drawbacks. Maybe drawbacks whatever strategies you are using requires more work. During lesson planning, It is true. Many teachers struggle to find the extra time in their schedule. Okay. The learning curve can be steep and some schools lack professional development resources. Learning curve, you know what is the learning curve? Very steep karanya, and it's more difficult to achieve according to the explanation of that. The learning curve is means the steep, so difficult to achieve. But we are creative enough to make it easier, yeah? Critics argue that there isn't enough research to support the benefits of differentiated instruction. That's why you try it out in your class and you can produce a paper. And then you must be developing, masih berkembang. It's still developing this instruction. Yeah? Okay? Now, shall we stand up and dance together before we go? I will share with you the these slides for the PowerPoint with Badian, and Badian is going to send it to all of you. I have a lot of friends, many. But you know, can I have the music? Before we go, we just although you don't like dancing, I like dancing anyway. Actually, I want to share it with you. That's a song. I don't know whether you are. Rhythm is also a good. Everybody stand up. Rhythm is a good energizer for the students. You see the rhythm? You know the song? I don't. Someone that I used to be. So now you can create any gestures you want, any steps you want. Oh, you see? Come on. Children. Teaching them gestures. Right hand. Left hand. Up. Side. Down. Forward. Up. Side. Down. You see? She can dance, you see? Are you sure? Are you sure? Very graceful. Astrid, you dance. This is the one.
Up, down, side, side, up, down, side,
nah, sekarang pagi.
You come to me. Okay, so okay, thank you very much for coming. Yeah. Shall we take pictures?
Banyak pencapaiannya
18 tahun. Terus untuk para alumni dan kelompok tahun.
I would like to invite all participants to have a photo session with Ms Luz Ismail. Can you please come forward, everyone?
Thank you.
Thank you.